Everybody at home, you ready? Baby, you got yours? All right, I need another one. Okay, we gotta get ready. We gotta get ready for this this premiere. I'm gonna have to run home and change real fast into something a little more premiere-ish. All right.
Here we go. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers yet again.
Cheers, everybody. Cheers, honey. So we have some other things in common too.
What's that?
Well, you both went to Gabriel Richard.
That's right.
Okay, I went to St. Thomas.
No way.
Yeah, and I'm a little older than you, so.
Oh, wow.
But did you go to St. Thomas too?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. My favorite
Who are some of your teachers?
That's what I'm about to tell you. Well, not my favorite one. She was the scariest one, Sister Mary Kay.
Yeah, of course.
Really? You know Sister Mary Kay?
Yeah, of course. She was our teacher.
Sister Mary Kay is famous in so many young people's nightmares.
Exactly. She scarred me for life.
She would love to hear that.
Scars on your
yeah. I didn't mean that. I actually never had her. I was too young, but Chris had her. Right?
Oh, that she was gone by the time you got there. Yeah, no, she was. I think her last year was maybe when I was in seventh grade, something like that. But yeah, I had her as a math teacher.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah, she made me wash makeup off my face, and
And she didn't even have any on.
Didn't like me. That wasn't funny, baby.
Oh, sorry. You can edit me out.
And then the priest too. I don't know if you remember Father Lungsford or Father Ed.
Yeah, Father Lungsford.
Oh, he was my favorite. I used to steal my uncle's fountain pens and gift wrap them and put them under his door. You know, just I had a crush on the priest. You know?
Yeah. Go figure.
He was a tough old dude, as I recall.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, I was an altar boy. I was very he was just a frightening individual.
I don't remember
him. Really?
I think I was before my time as well.
Okay, he was like a father figure to me. So anyway, that's something that we had in common. But what's your Ipsy tie, you guys?
Yeah.
Tell us something about Ipsy, since I am Ipsy girl, and I have to ask everybody that's on my show, how are you somehow, you know, influenced by Ipsy, related to Ipsy, an experience in Ipsy? We need to know something.
We had a lot of friends who grew up in Ipsy.
Okay.
Talal Arima, who's out in Los Angeles with us. My good friend Evan Burgess grew up in Ypsilanti. So I have many fond memories of going and going to Depot Town and cruising Washtenaw.
Mm-hmm.
Specifically, we would go to the Dairy Queen on Washtenaw.
Yep,
quite
I used to
often.
Work there too.
Yeah, another thing in common with Evan Burgess. So yeah, we would all, and we'd play a lot of sports and basketball, and Evan's dad lived, his backyard was that awesome park that was near the middle school. Do you remember that park? It was off of Washtenaw. I forget the street, but it was a great park. So we were there constantly playing football and basketball, and it was huge. So yeah, I have very fond memories of
good.
I think some of it, because we went to Catholic school,
mm-hmm.
you get kids from all over the place, right?
Yeah.
Right.
So, you know, if we had gone to public school, everybody would have been from our area and that kind of thing. But we had a lot of our best friends were from Ipsy, and they just
it's
came
very
to.
Very true.
And specifically, gosh, what was that Catholic school that used to St.
Francis?
No, it was one that only went up to fifth or sixth grade.
Oh, okay.
And then what happened was that a whole bunch of them came over mm-hmm. to St. Thomas mm-hmm. after that, so a lot of my best friends came from there.
Well, thank you so much for sharing that with us. I also wanted to talk a little bit.
Gus Macker.
Oh yeah, how can we forget the Gus Macker?
Honestly,
well,
that's
that?
Probably the most iconic.
And that was the 3-on-3
You don't know about that, Ipsy girl?
Oh no, Gus, right?
Well, Gus Macker was the name of the 3-on-3 basketball tournament. It was kind of mm-hmm. founded in Michigan, and the Ipsy Gus Macker was something we played in year after year.
Okay, that sounds so familiar to me.
And,
it was huge.
Reinerson Stadium parking lot is where they had it. Those were seminal moments in our Ann Arbor and Ypsilanti upbringings. Yes.
That's both sides of 23.
I love to hear that. That's 23. Right. Both sides of 23. That was good, baby.
Hey, I got to ask, compared to on the movie, the footage that you shot compared to how much makes it in the movie, what is that ratio?
It's it's not a high ratio at all. We have tons of, well, so I mean, there are different ways to look at it. There are some scenes that we cut altogether just to kind of hone the story down. But then even within each given scene, you usually have a whole bunch of different takes from a whole bunch of different angles. So, I mean, I really couldn't. Yeah. Our editor knows how many hours of footage we have, okay. And it's many, many hours, and it took her a long time to cull it down.
And what about funnyordie.com?
Yeah.
I had no idea that you guys were involved in that. People send me videos from the site all the time.
Oh, great.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. For years. So.
Yeah. So that site was founded by Will Ferrell and Adam McKay, and I'm president of production at Funny or Die, and actually got my job there because of the work that Chris and I were doing online had gotten noticed by some people, and they started featuring a lot of the videos we were working on, and that's
really
how I got my job at Funny or Die, and now I oversee a creative and production staff that makes about 20 original videos a month. We're very fortunate. We get to work with lots of well-known celebrities and comedians and up-and-coming actors, and it's really a great world to create and produce, and Chris always helps out and with different ideas and feedback on the site and videos, so he's a part of that too.
Yeah, it's a wonderful idea that you've definitely launched. Time Magazine even did a major piece on funnyordie.com, and they're saying that it's like the stand up of the future, the stand up comedy of the future.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think so? I mean, I guess obviously you do. Is it working for you? Is it profitable? And
We're on our way. I mean, I feel like online video in general has changed the landscape of just media and comedy, certainly. Before, when you would have to seek out a stand-up comedian in live shows, now so many people have their own websites, their own videos, they're on Twitter. It's just so much more accessible.
Oh, it's so right. From when I was young, there was like 5 Jewish guys that told all the jokes in the entire country. I mean, they were the same guys on, Ed Sullivan, whatever, on these shows. And
right.
They were at the Rooster Tail downtown, and it's unbelievable what's happened with comedy.
Now it's 20.
You got to tell him that was a good one.
That one was good. Well, yeah. See, he left me speechless. So that's something.
Shut up.
Okay, how are we doing here on time? The premiere is tonight, by the way, for Answer This, a red carpet premiere at the Michigan Theater.
We have a minute and a half.
We got to wrap this up.
Oh, yeah, wow.
Goes by fast.
Thank you so much.
Time flies when you're having fun.
That's right.
Time flies with Ipsy Girl.
Thank you for being on our show, and I hope that when you do your next movie, you'll come back and be on our show, and we'll help you as much as we can.
Yeah, that's a lot. We appreciate it.
Okay, well, thank you so much. This is Christopher and Michael Farah, the Farah brothers of AnswerThisTheMovie.com. And here we go. We're out of here. Well, we need 40 seconds, but I should shut up. It's okay. But people love this part. Let's have another drink. They still listen, even though they know they can't see us.
Well, they're Hollywood guys. Tell me, when you go, how do you pick out a plastic surgeon? Is it just word of mouth or...
Honey, we're still on the air. Don't ask them that kind of question.
You just watch whatever popular reality television show is on and go to that person.
That's true. Yeah, even get it for free if you're a contestant, right?
It's funny. I drive down the street all the time, and I wonder, because you see them everywhere, and I wonder, how do people know who are the good ones and who are the bad ones?
Exactly. I'd be scared. Excellent.
That's a wrap.
That's it. Oh, man, you guys. Cannot thank you enough.
Yeah,
you,
glad it worked out.
We really appreciate it.
Our pleasure.
I love your rapport. It's fantastic.